Alright, so here's my presentation on how to click to add title, and how to click to add subtitle. So you see these arrows? This is like a cursor, right? And it's directing you to like where you click, right? So first you gotta like make up. So like these arrows are to like help you like click and make a new title. This is 5 minutes.
All right. Sponsored by Shutterstock.
And then sometimes you get like so lost when you're trying to like to make a new title, right? And then you just like you just grab your pen and start confused screaming, you know? Oh, what the?
We know who this is.
So why make a title? Making a title helps illustrate a general idea. So like let's take this Vaporeon with the sand, for example. You can make your title like Sand Porion, you know? And then like everyone will want to watch it. And like they have an idea of what will be on the slideshow. Did it? Wait, okay.
What about the second reason, Sam?
Secondly, title has a bat word in it. And everyone like Booba, so
I want to gun down this slide.
I feel like I love this slide.
And when you make a title, you receive lots of love, like these emojis.
Oh my god.
You only shot.
Songs, what makes a title good? So titles help explain a deeper meaning. Like super deep, like 50 meters deep, okay? Like kids pool deep. And so without a title, it's too hard to figure it out. And an example is on the right, where that says, if you think you're gonna vaccinate my kids, this is the only kind of shot you're gonna get. And the song is called Vaccine Bad.
Presenter Sam, I have a question.
Here's an example of bad title. No title by real. Oh, but this is a good title called Untitled.
Damn.
Oh my god, Takeon. These are examples of good titles. Like 777. Oh my god, such deep meaning. Eternal.
Apelius, weapon of the faithful. YouTube.
Okay. The amount of meaning you get from these titles is like, it's like limitless, okay? So, you're gonna click to add title. You're gonna click to add text. Final thoughts. Click to add text.
I hate
what
this.
The fuck, Doug?
No punch.
And final.
Okay.
Can we take a solid 5 minutes to pray to Jesus?
That's so good.
Of course.
This name is Ellen Frank.
Why are there more? Why are there
more? Oh, come on.
What is this?
You were so close.
Sam, you're being right. So unprofessional right now.
This is Junk's bed and this is Junk's chair.
Ayo!
So close.
Is that it? The end.
It's just black.
Yeah.
10 out of 10.
Oh man, this is an interesting one, so.
Oh. What is this title?
Share your screen.
Okay. I'll share my screen.
Are you okay?
I think he's having a bad time.
He's having a seizure.
What?
Having a good
go ahead, complete it.
Okay.
Omer, you're not allowed to look through it.
I'm not looking through it.
It's a lottery.
I'm loving the color scheme already. I'm loving the color scheme. Reason number one, that color scheme, dude. Holy shit.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm here to present to you top 10 reasons why I am Virginia, not the other. Number one. Ladies and gentlemen, you know Virginia is the latest state in the United States of America, and you know I'm a lit just like this guy. Damn. Fascinating. Just like me. Just like Virginia.
It's
a fully prepared.
Is a number. Simply number. Three. We skip number two. Number two is for beta people. Number two is for the second state, New Jersey, which is insignificant. So we skipped the number three.
Why is
that? Ladies and gentlemen, did you know that Virginia has the best toilet paper in the United States of America? I didn't think you knew that. Damn. My good lord. Gentlemen, I'm just trying, don't got anything on our toilet paper.
Okay.
What is that accent?
Why is there no picture?
Why do you want a picture of that?
Reason number four. We here in Virginia do not take off any part of our bodies.
What the fuck?
We are born, we embrace. We are not chickens.
Cut your hair, dog.
I should not have taken a drink of water.
I'm a six. Did you know that Among Us was generated in Virginia? Don't look it up. The internet's lying to you. But let me tell you that 2020's humor was simply based off of Virginia with the introduction of the best kid game, Among Us. Yes, it was. Among Us is based off of Virginia, my friends.
Based off of Virginia.
Five.
It went back.
Why five now, man?
We skip reason number five. The number fifth reason for why Virginia is the best state and why I am Virginia is because five. If you understand it, if you get it. If you don't, then get out of this call.
Because five.
Wait, but it says hey. It says hey.
No, I know. Hey, now let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey. Ever see a demonstration of a modern rap?
Hey.
I can't drink water, bro.
Hey.
Oh shoot.
Oh my god.
You guys like Shakespeare? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I don't. Now, ladies and gentlemen, have you ever heard of the hit food chain Del Taco?
Del Taco, what the fuck?
I know you have. I know it's everyone's favorite restaurant. I know. We here in Virginia, we just love our Del Taco much. We eat too much of it, and we do what that title tells you to do. Now, see, I got this title from my friend Sam from this previous presentation. That's a great title, you know. Can you agree, Sam?
No.
Well, you really don't know.
Sam's so disappointed.
You clearly didn't learn.
You thought this originated in Alabama? Ladies and gentlemen, do you know that Alabama is Virginia? I didn't think you
Sweet home Virginia.
Oh my god. Oh my
god. Ladies and gentlemen, sweet home Virginia. And if Alabama's got that and Virginia's got that, then you know I got that too because I'm Virginia.
He is Virginia, bro.
Reason number nine. That's my 10 reasons. That's the 9th reason. The 9th reason is that those are my 10th reasons. Smash that subscribe button. Ring that bell signal that demons have invaded our world and I don't want to be Virginia anymore. Please get me out. Nightmare.
Alright.
Okay. He is done being Virginia.
He's no longer Virginia.
He wants to be Virginia anymore.
Let's go.
How's it going?
Okay. Whose presentation was that?
Alex.
I'm guessing how did you figure out it's me?
I think it was Kawhi.
What?
Yeah, those are very Kawhi jokes.
Yeah, really
what? Very,
Kawhi,
very
you
Kawhi
made that slideshow, right?
Wait, what slideshow?
Oh.
Alright, I think this is fit for Alex. Yes.
All right, what's up, viewers? Today we're going to be going how to summon Among Us in real life. So why would you want to summon Among Us? It's really simple. It's based off the hit game by Inner Sloth, also notable for making Henry Stickman. It's fun for the whole family, good for your health, helps me burn 6,000 calories per day, every single minute of the hour, on the second, and it decreases. Step one of becoming Among Us is to do task. It is very important to do the task. This will attract crewmate. However, while doing the task, do not do them badly, or else you can summon imposter. See, when you do it correctly, you get plus 15 social credit. If you do it wrong, though, you might end up becoming imposter. Here's how we're excited. We're going to go over this entire wiki now. So, tasks that work on the objectives of crewmates. They're in gameplay and Among Us.
All crewmates
increase skills. That's a good idea. Let me pull it easy, baby.
The fact that this, at least, like,
we're going on. I'm going free. Going free.
Right.
Oh my god.
Alright.
Article title
death. Let's go. Imposter.
Oh my gosh. No.
Alright.
I don't have edit permission, so I'll make sure to add those after this. Anyways. Right. Step two. Clean vent. Your house has air vents, you must clean them. Fresh air is good. Yeah, I don't have really anything to add for that. That's just kind of good advice. Also, it gets rid of mold. Three, Among Us potion. Make Among Us potion. Do not make the Among Us potion. These two are very different and could result in disastrous... Wait, where did I just go? Disastrous side effects. See, here, you can see you become fantastic results. And if you go here, you become Disguised Toast, who after saying he made his last Among Us video, proceeded to make 5 more Among Us videos because he no longer gets any views.
Dang.
Sponsor, Facebook. Fellas, I'm gonna tell you, the League of Legends program is going to blow your mind. I know we were talking about Among Us, but League of Legends... First of all, let's lock in. I can't check this out. You can push spells to get the perfect summoner spells. You can push items, which is going to give you the perfect items, and push runes. Push. I click push, all because they get everything perfect. So after it does all the work for you in champion select, pick us out.
Oh my god, you're
Let's go over that again, fellas.
No!
Step 4, buy a spaceship. Assuming both the net price and construction cost of a 2 mile, oh my god, low orbit craft is within your limit. If this is not the case, feel free to forfeit most, if not all, your physical possessions to pawn shops or online auctions. Doing so will bolster your retirement savings and investment section. Tax Form 550 Section 2B. Invest these in the required materials. Also ask Elon Musk for money, because, you know, obviously, Elon Musk definitely will give you away free money. You spam him on Twitter.
Step 5, cool.
Know who is sus. Finish task and drink Among Us potion. Will me sus. Dispose of them. Find who is sus. Step 2, use method. Chunk stack. Next snap. Knife. America. 3, do not run out of mana. Step 4, gas. Step 6, Soviet Union is now decentralized. Congratulations. How long does this go for? Brilliant. Step 6. Yeah, citizens. Russia is yours through Among Us. Now sell or their loyalty. All citizens are crewmates. H:P=1 and H:P<1. Check conditions and find p-value. Thank god. We don't have to actually do that, because that sucks. Step 7. Among Us IRL. Now that everyone is Among Us, you sacrifice them all. Roughly 10,000 to summon crewmates. Crewmates have to live on spaceship or they will cease. You can see here that even though the human population is 8 billion, there's only 10,000. This is because you have to take all their buddies and meld them into a single Among Us. Thank you, existence. We will now go over the Wikipedia. So, there are 4 different types of tasks. Short tasks, often required a single stage and take very little time to do depending on the player's speed, such as chart course and clean vent. Long tasks usually have multiple stages or force the player to spend a long time, such as start reactor. Visual attacks are performed from animation visible to all players. Completing a visual task in front of the group is an easy way to confirm a crewmate, as other players will see the task be completed, proving the player's innocence. Visual attacks, visual effects. This Wikipedia is poorly edited. What? Common tasks are assigned to every player in a game. If one or more common tasks have been said, they gain attention.
We can handle like a really, really bad presentation.
Hey, I wasn't done. I'm starting over from the top.
No, who thinks they can handle a really, really bad one?
Yeah, I'll go.
Okay.
Hit me up.
Are you sure?
Hit me up. Wait, what do you mean by bad? Wait, define bad.
Like, as in Felix took like 5 minutes to make this.
Okay, alright. Hit me up.
Are you sure?
No, of course I'm not. Shit.
It's
okay,
high-end
production. Okay, well, I sent it to you, so you have to do it.
It's high-end production. High-end production.
No worries.
That smells like poop.
You do.
What do you mean? How do you know?
Tad Polish.
Damn.
Hey everyone. Welcome to my presentation about Boolean moves. To first start, I must introduce you that I am actually part Austrian and just a tad bit Polish, around 3-4%. This will be important later. I'll explain it as we go on, but just bear with me, okay? I also chose this computer background because I'm very smart because I'm Austrian, and every
every single Austrian person smarter than you. So function and dualism, which are two very linked ideas. So the importance of this transition is that I have to reintroduce this concept in order to get it into the minds of plebeians like you. Now, I'm not really sure if you guys understood that. Maybe I have to do it again, but we'll see. Okay, so to understand this four quadrant material of the Boolean function, we first have to go over to what exactly WK1 means. So WK1 just means that we are so while K equals one, we have four of them. So while K equals one, we loop that four times. Okay. So all these numbers down here, I'm not exactly sure what they mean. I kind of forgot, but I'm pretty sure they're in
Wait, but you're Austrian. How did you forget?
Listen, man. I'm the one doing the presentation.
It's Polish bit.
I'm Polish right now. Okay. I'm Polish every few minutes, and right now I'm Polish, and I forgot exactly what else we'll be doing here. Okay. So these are the dates that I wrote down. Each function has to function at a specific interval.
Can I just say, this is the slide for like the sketches. This is nothing. This is the sketch of the slide.
Dude, I literally, shut up. Like, I'm literally part of you. To help you visualize, to help you feel great from this tedious mental activity, I prepared an image of a twerking dog for you. This is what we call a refreshment, okay? that we really have to hammer at home.
Professor, what do you do in your spare time?
That can be shown in the top right-hand corner. The while sign of the place loop, otherwise abbreviated as a hold loop, can be utilized the utmost efficiently with a cobweb index at strategy to find certain protagonists in a cobweb and process, usually using the sub-sandwich go. Now, the sub-sandwich go is really interesting, because you can use it as any single you can use it in tandem with a cobweb to make any kind of loop you want, even a hold loop, which is really interesting and cool. An example can be shown on the left.
Professor.
So these are my two cousins that just in a school project. They won first place at the computer Olympics. This is an animation of them winning the gold medal. That's what we're doing. Now we have to, the ecological footprint when you do the loop is deep, and I have to, every single time you do one of these loops on exactly Tuesday, January 30th, you leave behind a massive ecological footprint. So that really affects the rabbit and coyote population. So it's actually so bad that we have a name for it called Conk Day, and a lot of people dread it. A lot of people really they make all these graphs and try and interpret what exactly it's supposed to mean, but nobody has actually tried and figured out Conk. Look at how big those footprints are. It's actually kind of scary, honestly. So, this is a visual representation of what happens if you let...
He's blanked.
Professor, why haven't you activated Windows?
No, I'm sorry. I was just coming for the fact that I accidentally put one of my League of Legends clips in here, but I'm gonna play it a few times to really let it sink in.
Yeah.
The Wawa in the corner got me kinda acting up, though.
It's just there. It's there to help you do that.
It's still fucking there. It's been there for like the entire...
It's called, if I put four pictures of the dog and then I put zero in the next slide, you're gonna suffer from withdrawal. That's why there was three in the last slide, two in this slide. So in page 48 of your science notebook, you'll find a tape in states of matter notes. So there's four phases of matter, and I'll list all four right now. That's League of Legends, and then the last one's gas. That means we skip the rest of the slide. Now, I don't want you to not worry about that. That's exactly what this says. Skip four lines in between, okay? So whenever you see that, you have to skip the rest of the slide. The health continuum. So this part is really important, and it relates back to everything that I've ever said before. So what you see here is a very unhealthy Sova. What he just tried to do was he tried to MLG gamer this Phoenix, but he got shot while he was trying to do it. Now, this is an exact example of how you shouldn't do a health continuum chart, and I want you all to know that, you see how he swings that axe, misses to the left, and he just absolutely just, like, point blank, like Phantom. Like, it's embarrassing.
It's a vandal!
told you that in the past. I was going on.
What?
Map of the U.S.
So this is a map of South Africa. All of these separate states, the ones that are colored red are the ones that have these functions implemented, and the ones that are colored greens are the ones that have been absolutely decimated by the carbon footprints and do not exist anymore. Damn. So just take a good look at that and really know how much this impacts your life. This species that has an ape on their chest and a human face, they're extinct because of this. It's really sad. And this is a visual representation of me after we finish this presentation, because I know that you guys all love it so much. That's it.
I like your legs.
Brilliant. That was brilliant.
Beautiful.
Good work.
I think I'm ready
I
to start Facebook.
I regret calling this presentation bad. Anyways.
I am ready to create Facebook.
Damn.
I believe the correct terminology is metaphor.
Okay. Random.
I believe the correct term is you shove that up your butthole.
Oh, they shove a metal up my what?
Up your metal hole.
Oh.
Metal hole? Is that what you just said?
Yes, sir.
I love Mark the metaverse.
Oh my god, what if we fucked in the metaverse? Oh my god.
True.
What if you didn't say that?
What if we said that louder?
What if you screamed
it? It's not a progressive.
I didn't look at a single thing. I legit closed my eyes and clicked on present. You guys are just as blind to this as I am.
Oh, I just got flashbang.
Today we start off with a flashbang. This is a representation of every single Valorant player in real life after the flashbang wears off. Reality is just a flashbang. Wake up. Actually, this is William. and he's been a very dirty boy, as you can see, and he's very sad because he's dirty. Will you help me with another flash? Oh fuck, I'm blind again. No. As the flash we find Mark Zuckerberg. Now, thank goodness the frog was dirty, because witness how happy Mark Zuckerberg is because of the extinction of the frogs as a result of them being so dirty, right?
No, William.
William is nothing in comparison to Fox, man. Look at them go. I hear Mark Zuckerberg is extending a cordial greeting to us, right?
Yes.
Actually, his name is Zark Muckerberg. So, I can't read that. What does that say?
You might be thinking, yeah, why am I a lizard man with short-term memory loss qualified to teach you how to wash your head frog?
Let's go, William!
So first you take a matchstick and you point it at your local graph. That'll allow you. Another flashbang. Why is there so much yellow and white? I can't read it. What does it say? I would read it.
It's the same thing again. It's the same thing.
What do you mean, same thing?
You might be thinking, why am I a lizard man with short-term memory loss qualified to teach you how to wash your pet frog? Okay, okay.
So he's gonna show us now. I'm going to allow Zark Muckerberg here to take the microphone, and he's going to explain why he's qualified, okay?
Hey guys, so this is William. He's very dirty, and so they come in two species, Pepes and Kermits. Kermits,
they're different.
Audience participation. We're gonna get Mark off.
So you guys.
Can I answer?
Bro, I didn't even say the fucking question. Calm down. So hold your horses. Audience participation. What type of frog is William? Any takers? Correct. He is a little fucking ass of a bitch. So
the first step in washing your frog is to put him in the trash can, right where he belongs. As you can see, William is eccentric about this new change of setting. He is very happy because he knows he is about to be cleaned. Here is a picture of William, our sample frog, enjoying being with his people. In addition, make sure to say, William, you're a disappointment to your family. This will allow him to feel sadness even more so, and his tears will wipe his skin.
What? Let's go, William.
Is that his mom?
No comment.
Let's go, William.
Step
right, minds think alike.
I'm scared where this will go.
Oh, okay. So this is an example of someone using a little too much force when petting William. As you can see, he has formed a fucking concave pattern in his spine by petting too hard. Okay, and you don't want to do this. Instead,
concave?
Actually, this is not enough. Is what I meant to say. This is not that we need to karate chop him down the middle in order to achieve maximum cleanliness. Okay. See the picture for a good example of how hard you should pet William. Flashbang. Step 3. So, do you remember how we karate chopped William, right? Smack in the middle of his spine.
Nope.
That was to allow more surface area for the soap to seep into. For instance, using the soap of the bar, using the bar soap, it creates a perfect slot for William to absorb the soap.
Wait, Among Us reference?
Actually, this is a minion from Despicable Me colored red, but I thank you for your audience participation. However, this in the bottom, in the bottom right-ish side, this is SpongeBob, a popular character from pop culture. You might recognize him as he is here for you to see on today's presentation, which is about cleaning frog, baby crying, being beaten with mop.
Okay.
Why is the baby cleaning?
It's Harry Potter. It's a crying baby.
Do you
baby
not
and
use your baby to clean?
Is it getting bonked?
Harry Potter.
So as you can see here, the mop is broken. We need to use the baby and put it on the mop instead in order to clean William. Make sure. Now, while you might be thinking that we are cleaning the skin, we also need to clean it from the inside out. Ensure that he swallows all of the soap and cleaning supplies to clean his insides.
What about the child?
Bing. Oh, then the child.
Bing.
Flashbang.
Step 4. William, upset that you have fed him such things, may feel very angry. How do we deal with this? Uh-oh. So here you can see a diagram of possible solutions for William. The first and most obvious choice is to console him. Consoling angry people is useful because fuck. Next, fuck. Now he is very happy and has fallen in love with your juicy, fat, voluptuous.
No!
Is this the pacifist round or the genocide round?
William, no!
Tags, mind break.
Step 5. Date your William.
Oh, no.
Take your William out to a beautiful dinner filled with many blueberries that have turned black, strangely, as shown by these blueberries that are black. They are not blackberries. Repeat. I forgot I was Zark Muckerberg. The end. Thank you. From Zark Muckerberg.
Okay.
Truly inspiring. I want to get a William now.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
William, no.
Professor, can you show us the
William
genocide route?
William is happy, Omer. William.
The genocide route is very similar to the pacifist route, except you console him, then he kills you.
Wait,
the
genocide
route is not genocide of the monsters, it is genocide of the humans.
Oh, I was saying that William is very happy.
Yeah. Oh.
Was this Sam? I bet it was Sam.
Huh? Yeah.
Oh, that wasn't mine. No,
I thought it was yours, Sam.
No. That's Vivian. No, it's Vivian, yeah.
Makes sense.
But William.
You two
William.
Are the ones that said you were photoshopped.
I only photoshopped one image.
Yeah. Also, Brendan, I just sent you one.
I see.
Bro, okay. William is thinking the thoughts of real men out here.
Okay, it's time to lie.
William is a winner.
How do I?
True.
Win like William.
Oh, true.
William. Share my screen.
William.
Let's see.
William should change his name to William because he doesn't take any L's.
Nunu okay. And William.
Do you guys think there's William no Coochie more. Is good?
Wait, what?
Do you guys think William Coochie is good Coochie?
No.
How to be a good driver.
Oh my god, you
know I'm the best driver. This isn't right. I should be the best. I hate you.
Why? Why presentation? Why? Many of you, permits, but no license. You're a bunch of losers, you know.
What is that, Cybertron?
Going to be driver soon. Must learn basics. The first basic is by slapping lots of Japanese pornography onto your car, your road safety will increase because no one wants to drive in the same lane as you. Figure two, I can see that by driving around in a toy car, you can assert your Sigma dominance.
I don't know about you, but like I'm driving in the same lane as
Shut
that.
Shut up! I hate you.
Homer is going to be driving one-handed.
My right arm is stronger than my left.
Incredible. I passed on my course. Okay, I tried. I had the license. I can drive. I don't know who that is, though.
I think Brendan looked different. I don't know.
I don't know, man.
I think he grew out his hair.
Incredible.
Yeah, I think Brendan.
Oh, is this the person driving the first car? This is the person driving the first car, right?
See those 14 errors? That means the driver didn't cheat, which means pass.
Professor, why does the driver have two nostrils and two mouths?
The driver is a spawn from this guy called Satan, right, from hell. You might have heard of him in the Bible.
No,
you need to read that.
Can you elaborate on the Bible for me? Can we go through that?
So the Bible is a religious book, right? It's sort of the foundations of Christianity, right? Follows
what's
this cool
what's religion?
It's when I say I'm better than you.
Can you read
I
the
am.
Bible for us?
Yeah, sure. Well, let's schedule that in another time. Anyways.
What's another time, Professor?
When I can drive.
What kind of last name is Cardinal?
If you can drive.
Main point. See, this is the main point, because you'll be like a lion. You'll roar. You'll assert your dominance. Okay, prioritize yourself over others. Sigma mindset. You have places to be and people to meet. No time to wait for others.
Is that William in the corner?
Maybe.
Holy shit.
Don't
He's
know
so
what
clean.
Others have to do. They don't have anything.
He's so clean from
see,
the procedure.
Do you see all these people here? Right, if you can, right, just crank up the speed, right, and then run him over.
What's one of these are you, William? I mean, Professor.
It's me, Professor,
William after.
Christopher. Professor Christopher. Professor Christopher.
No.
Are you the purple guy?
See, actually, you know what? The main point, run over Omer first, right? And then anybody who looks like these guys. Anyone who's different, really.
Oh,
you
Jesus.
Are important. Run them all over, you know?
William, no!
Just make sure that your car doesn't get blood splashed in a time. That's also important.
Yeah,
because
that ruined the Japanese art.
Or maybe it'd make it more interesting.
Yeah, exactly. Cross it.
Every psychological
time.
Manga.
No.
Oh, God.
Go as fast as possible. Why go slow when you can get to the place faster and faster? You know, you can be like this Ferrari, Mercedes, whatever, right? Less time on street, less time wasted. Exactly. See, that's why if you're driving on the right side of the road and you see the left side, it's open, just drive down there. Right?
Go down the right side, they'll move.
Exactly. You can drive wherever you want on the road, really.
Wait, Professor? Excuse me?
Yeah.
I did really bad on my last exam. I was thinking you could help me after school.
Oh my god.
God.
Professor, I have a second question.
Oh my.
No.
Professor, what's a K-mile?
A K-mile? So it's a lot like Florida.
Wait,
ounces,
is it like
right?
Is it like Korean pop? Korean
no. Okay, let me explain. So you know what a Florida ounce is, right?
Yeah, I know what a Florida.
It's a lot like
ounce.
That, but it's potassium mile. That means when you drive on it, right, the road will smell like bananas. Don't even sound like a banana. In fact, you should try it out sometime. And to the grade right after school. I'm gonna fail you again. You do not challenge my Sigma authority,
Professor. Whose banana does it sound like?
Mine.
Yeah, his. Okay.
Alex, can you demonstrate what your banana sounds like?
Honk at anyone slow in front of you. Okay, they waste your time for being slow. Show them they need to move out of the way or speed up. Well, you see, honking is sort of like a last resort, right? They don't see... there's a little annotation here. If you have a firearm, right? Just, you know... Roll the window down, pull it out, and just put a few pot shots, you know? If they want to go slow, then let's slow them down forever.
Oh, Professor, can I hit a few warning shots in their skull?
We don't do warning shots here. We go straight for the kill. But I like the spirit. And yeah, make sure to teabag them and tonk too. That's always important.
Teabag them with your car?
Exactly. If someone still doesn't move, honk this. The Morse code says, I don't know, let me read this for a moment.
Fuck you.
I don't know what
I
this-
see an O.
It says that, give me your money, you suck, and, I'm gonna slaughter your family. I'm like-
It says, fuck you.
Exactly. Wait, does it actually? Wait, it does, doesn't it?
Yes, yeah.
That's
But you said that.
Oh!
Holy shit! As you and Morse code, send the message, assert the dominance, shoot them, crack a whip. See, you can be like this, pink-haired person, right? That's you. You'll have pink hair, you'll wear awesome pajamas, right? And this, and all these JoJo drivers, you'll show them who's the top dog. No.
Professor,
you want JoJo? Yeah.
And he could put his cockyo in my ass.
Now, that's an interesting point, right? However, you need to assert your-
Professor, is that a JoJo's reference?
JoJo's reference!
Yes. Yes, it is.
Professor, I have another question.
God.
Yes.
Is the man with the whip targeting the black lady?
Yes. And it's a subtle reference to how no matter how much driving skills you exercise, right? You always got to be racist in the end.
Okay. Hey, but the black lady looks like she's cheering him on.
Whip her.
He does not look very happy. I'm not gonna lie.
Remember, racism on the road.
Subjective. Everyone shows their happiness.
People walking on day streets. Don't let day people walk and stop it because you're walking. If they see someone walking on the crosswalk, just keep going. They have legs. You can run, you know. See.
Professor, I have a question.
Yeah.
Professor, is Barbie an alpha, beta, sigma, or figglebottom male?
I say figglebottom. See, you can run over the legs, right? Because you can survive without them. Why would anyone need them, you know? If anything, you're just doing them a favor. So you know what? Speed up, knock out their legs.
Thank you, Professor.
Yeah.
You could knock up my legs anytime.
What the hell?
Are you gonna say, Professor, can I see your legs?
No.
What?
Like, how are you seeing your legs? I'm gonna have to ask my assistant Barbie here to run you over. Okay, I'm busy, you know, I'm on quotas. You
in her plastic recycled milk carton of a
professor,
car?
Professor, excuse me, Professor?
Yeah?
Professor, why are you allowing a woman to assist you?
Because I felt like it.
Professor? Professor?
I make my own
Professor,
rules.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Why are you letting a woman drive?
I'm sorry, no. You got me there.
The real question.
Don't worry, I'll make her make me a sandwich when I get home. We'll be even. Oh, if you run someone over, part one, it is not your fault. It is never your fault. Never, okay? No matter what.
They
it's
cut
always
the, way
the other person's fault, you know? Should have moved out of your way. You know, they shouldn't even exist. You're doing them a favor. Just knock them over like bowling pins. Not your fault. Believe in yourself.
Okay.
Part two. Cop on the face? They'll understand. See, police also drive, right? And they need to get places. So they'll run over some people too. This
Professor,
means that.
Why is the woman still driving?
It's a very great mistake.
Because he wants two sandwiches. Because he wants two sandwiches.
Exactly. Make it three.
An hour a sandwich, dude.
See, police will understand, right? They also run people over too. And if you don't, you can run them over, right? Or you can tell them that you also run people over. Therefore, you don't get to look like this stand on. You suck. And run them
Professor,
over again.
Professor,
yeah?
I didn't know you were sponsored by iStock Photo.
Yeah, I'm sponsored. I'm better than you. I run you over.
Wait, but Professor, I'm not a woman.
You're a woman now. I don't care.
Oh,
if you run someone over, Russian text, you get a free kill. See, 300 gold. Free Reggie. Better go for the kids going to the school next. I hate children, you know? Alright, so if you see one of those buses, right? They have these, like, blinking lights, right? School buses. That means that you should, just, you know, give them a fender bender and make it go boom. See? You'll even get a free paint job while you're at it, you know, with all the blood and all that. Can you even be, like, one of these leaguers?
Leaguers?
Yeah, League of Legenders, I don't know.
This man is level 15, has 16 kills, and only has 147 farm.
It's a
yeah, because that's how League of Legends.
Hey, LS Watcher.
I played more League than you, so shut up.
Wait, which champ is that?
It's a Tristana.
What?
I mean, it's Barbie. What do you mean?
Barbie OTP.
Into the Barbie.
Professor,
thank you for watching. Yeah.
Professor, can I ask a classmate a question?
Sure.
Hey, Alex.
No.
How many sandwiches has Vivian made you?
Not enough.
Well, oh God. Let's run Vivian over. Thanks for watching. Be sure to practice offensive driving.
Emphasis on the offensive.
Dad burn pal.
They always talk about defensive driving, but where's the
offensive in that
driving?
We only run over.
Offensive in the wrist.
We only run over minorities.
Ideology. Oh my God.
Wait, guys. Okay, real talk question. If I masturbate with virgin coconut oil, is it still a virgin?
What?
But then, like, if you do it with extra virgin, it only turns.
Oh my God.
Oh. I've been
all I know is asking that question to Jung in the next presentation.
That is all of them.
Sam, don't you know not to let women drive? Sam, you made that, right? Sam, you made that, right?
Yeah.
Why would you let a woman drive? What's up with that?
It's just a toy, man.
Do we need to have a conversation?
I'm sorry.
Oh, so now women are toys. Okay.
We've had this conversation before. I didn't want to revisit it.
Women are toys. What do you mean?
Yeah, you better. Yeah, you're backpedaling.
Wait, is Kawhi still here? Oh, God, Kawhi is still here.
You did this whole time.
I wonder why.
She's rethinking her choices.
Oh, hey, Chris. Chris missed all the action.
Bro,
yeah, we were just talking about how women are toys.
And exactly, and that sandwiches.
Sandwich making toys.
I also made a peer edited essay on Among Us.
With I talked about why I'm
are
Virginia.
You here after school today?
No. I'm fishing.
Professor, can you be after school today?
I'm fishing. My name is not Christopher. It's not after school.
Sir Christopher, PhD in misogyny.
I'm PhD in misogyny, but my name is not Christopher.
You got, you know, fucking economist, ecologist, misogynist.
Exactly.
I'll just take the last one.
You got the
one.
Whole gang, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh man, Professor Christopher taught me a lot today. I learned so many new things, like how to wash a William, how to be a misogynist, and to make women make my sandwiches.
Awesome. Okay, I'm gonna get a drink of water.
Awesome. There was more.
Dude.